guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel Phoenix Creation. So as you can already see by the title and the thumbnail, today I'm gonna make this cute little DIY sewing machine. And not to forget guys, this was highly requested by one of my very dear subscribers. So I thought why not, let's try this today and let's get into the video to see how it's made. So for this I'll need cardboard, card paper, some paints and glue. So let's get started. So guys, as you can see, I've taken these two cardboard cutouts and this is the size and shape, and then this is the third one, as you can see. So I'll just fold them accordingly and then I'll just start gluing them together. So now as you can see, I've made these lines over here. I'll just cut the first part. After that, I'll just make some cuts over here so that it can get folded inside it in this way. So once it's done, now I'll just take another cardboard cutout which has two holes on each of the sides, and then this is the craft wire which is easily bendable. I'll just cover that with white plain paper and then fold it like a handle, and then I'll just insert this into the holes which I've made on the cardboard, and then I'll just glue it with these tiny pieces of cardboard circle so that it will lock the handle like this way. And then I'll just take this part with the hole I made there. So I'll just take these two together and then I'll just complete the second side covering this. Okay, so once it's done, now as you can see this, the handle is also locked properly. I'll just take this cardboard cutout and I made this line, as you can see. I'll just now start measuring it and then I'll just fold and then I'll just cut off this part. And I'll stick like this, folding. Guys, if you find difficulty in sticking it completely like this, then you can follow the other step I'm showing. You just can start sticking it and cut it part by part so that you can stick it one by one. In this way, it will be easier for you to make this. So likewise, I'll just start sticking these parts. Now this part for the inside part of the sewing machine. Okay, so after that, this is the last part which we'll attach it. So I'll just glue this also. After doing this, as you can see, the edges are not proper. So I'll just start using my paper clay and I'll just start smoothing out the edges. So this paper clay gives out a very pure and smooth finishing. So as you can see, once it's nice and dry, as you can see this, I'll just start making some detailing like the regulators of the sewing machine. So I'll just start putting this paper clay over there also. And then this is the cardboard stripe. I'll just fold it a little bit and then make it a ring like shape in this way. After attaching this, I'll just use this ring and attach there. And then over here also, I'll just start making some buttons, more buttons over here using the paper clay. And then this is the final part, guys. I'll just start painting this in with complete white acrylic paint. And I'm going for white sewing machine, so I'll just paint a white paint. So after this, I'll just use a craft wire and I'll just insert it over here. So this will be where the thread will get attached, and then I'll just cover it with little bit of paper clay again, and then I'll just start painting the remaining part. So as you can see, I have done it, and now this is just some tiny more detailings which I'll be sticking over here on top of the sewing machine on one side, and then these cardboard cutouts on the regulators. So once it's done, now I'll just start doing the second coat of the acrylic paint, because I was not satisfied with how it turned out in the first coat. So I'll just start painting it again, and then I'll just use the lightest shade of pink, you can say the baby pink paint, and I'll just start painting it some designs and some detailings also. So this will be the design. Now for some on the regulators also. So once it's done, I'll just use this card paper, silver card paper, and I'll just attach it over here where the needle will be, and then I'll just take this very tiny craft wire and this silver card paper. So this will be the needle, as you can see this, and now it has a hole. I made a hole already on the sewing machine, so I'll just attach there. After this, I'll just take my tiny and thinnest brush and I'll just start painting this black lines with black acrylic paint over here. So this will be the markings, the numberings over here, and then over here also. So once it's done, now I've just taken a wire which is of a headphone wire which I don't use anymore. So this is white in color, and if you don't have white, you can also paint it, and then you just have to make this plug. It's very easy. You just have to take these two tiny wire and then this cardboard cutout. So it will give you a shape like this, and then you just have to attach it to the wire and then start painting this also with white acrylic paint, because the complete machine is white. And then I'll just make a hole on the back side of the machine and just attach this. So as you can see, it's now done. And this is the handle. So guys, this machine is now ready, and here's what it looks like after it gets completed. So I was really happy and shocked also, because it was just looking like a real sewing machine, but in a miniature version obviously, because that's what our channel is all about. So this is the final product, guys. Adorable that I just couldn't stop myself from playing with it. So here's a clipping of how I play. So guys, this is the plug obviously, and then I've taken this bright pink fabric. This is a very tiny piece of fabric, and now I'm just trying to stitch it with my miniature sewing machine, and I just use the regulators to mark the length and the indication. And then this is the thread. This is the button, guys. So now I'll just start sewing this. So that's how I play. So this is the final video, guys. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And make sure you hit the bell icon so that whenever I post a new video, you will be notified. Till next time, bye-bye.